Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week. I'm Nate Long, along with John Clifford and Howard Kroll. We're at Cameron Stadium. Also with us, Eric and Pam Baxter. They're our film crew, and Shelly Gray is our film crew assistant. We want to thank Page Employment and Seaboard Security for making this game possible, as well as other sponsors we'll talk about during the half, but especially Page Employment and Seaboard Security. If you enjoy watching this game, well, you should appreciate those two companies. And you should also, if you're interested in buying a copy, contact those two companies, because copies of these games are available for sale. It is halftime. The score, Messalonsky 14, Bangor 7. Howard, you have some first half stats for us?
Yes, I do, and I'll start off with the Bangor Rams. Running the ball 10 times for 71 yards was Nick Payson. Brian Hackett had one carry for 3 yards. Brian Hackett, also the quarterback, was 3 for 9. But 56 yards. He had 2 interceptions. 1 was returned for 7. His 1 completion was to Anthony DeRocher for 56 yards, the first play of the game, for a touchdown. For the Messalonsky Eagles, Chris Duffy had 10 carries for 70 yards. Josh Cody, the fullback, had 4 carries for 13 yards. Justin Matos had 4 carries for 17 yards. Ted Fabian, the quarterback, had 2 carries for 0 yards. Danny May had 1 carry for 5 yards. Ted Fabian, also the quarterback, was 5 for 9 for 110 yards. 1 completion to Wayne Evans for 26 yards, and 4 completions to Justin Matos for 84 yards. Very impressive half for the Messalonsky Eagles, if I do say so myself.
84 yards to Matos. Those are pretty big yards. Some of those completions, you had a 38-yarder, a 27-yarder, 1 for 15 yards. And then Duffy on the ground was really held in check until that last carry he had in the second quarter there, where he broke it for 32 yards to set up a chance to throw the ball and get into the end zone. They weren't able to, but besides that, you take away that 32-yard gain, and in the first half, he only had 38 yards. This is a guy who's broken 200 yards twice this season. 6 of his 7 games this year, he's broken 100 yards. Of course, the team's one loss, Messalonsky's one loss to Mount Blue. Duffy only had 11 yards. They were able to keep him in check. The captains are out on the field again discussing what will happen to begin the second half. We would expect Messalonsky to be receiving the ball, and that's what will happen. Messalonsky will receive. Bangor will kick off with the win. They will be going from left to right.
You have to admit, six of Messalonsky's points came on the defense side of the ball with that interception by Fabian with an 18-yard run in. So that right there was a good effort on the defensive part to get 6 points on the board for Messalonsky.
That's true. The defense getting on the board and giving Messalonsky the lead. Bangor, as Howard mentioned, going through the stats, scored on their first play from scrimmage. It was that 56-yard touchdown pass, and they haven't scored since. That happened at the 11. That happened 16 seconds into the game, 11:44 mark of the first quarter. So Bangor looking to get things going on offense again.
Tyson Barron looking to send this one hopefully deep for Bangor.
And we are set for the kickoff. Tyson Barron, as John mentioned, the kicker for the Rams, back to receive the kick. Chris Duffy and Danny May. Duffy is the back to the left, and he will get the kickoff. He'll take it from his own 11-yard line. Nice move right there to get outside and then brought down at the 25-yard line.
Tyson Barron, the kicker on that one, in on the tackle. That's quite the effort. Kicks and makes the tackle. Not bad for a, if I'm mistaken, that young man is a junior at Bangor High. So you'll be seeing him next year.
And he sure can kick the ball. His long field goal of the season so far is 37 yards. He's 3 for 6 kicking field goals. But Messalonsky has the ball right now. The ball spotted at the 25-yard line. Their quarterback, Ted Fabian, under center. The tailback, Chris Duffy, keep an eye on him. He gets the call. Big hole and up the middle. He spins out of a tackle, still going, and is brought down across the 40-yard line. Well, they spot him right on the 40.
Duffy going right up the middle, going right over Jamie Bunnell and Colin Clifford, taking it up the middle, gets open, breaks the tackle with a nice spin move, gets a couple more yards out of it. So there you go. Meslonsky comes out of the chute with a running play. First down to move the chains.
Brought down by Vananastein, but not after picking up a first and 10 from their own 40. One back. The tailback is Duffy. Josh Cody also back there, the fullback. Duffy, the tailback, gets the call, and he's wrapped up. Finally dragged down after a gain of a couple.
Duffy going to the right there, going over Colin Clifford and Luke Fakita. Did I get that right?
Fakita.
Going to that side. Didn't get much of a gain, but a gain of 2 yards. It looks like they're going to move the offense by keeping the running game going.
Nick Buchanan in on the stop. Andrew Trundy trying to clog up the hole. Second down. Justin Matos goes wide left. Fabian will roll and look to Matos. This one is picked off. Intercepted by Payson. Flag down on the play. Nick Payson got the interception. They were looking for Matos. They had a lot of success during the first half passing to the big receiver. This play, a block in the back against Bangor, but that will be after the interception, so Bangor will take over on the turnover. First down and 10.
Matos was open again, but Nick Payson came out of nowhere, jumped up, caught that ball, gives Bangor their first possession of the second half.
Nice pickoff, like you said, by Payson. Have an eye for the ball and to come up with a key interception, because like you said, Matos was wide open.
Exactly, and he didn't just knock the ball down. He actually had the chance to grab it, keep it, bring it in, and get a couple yards out of it. They penalize him on that penalty, but hey, Bangor gets the ball back. First time this half.
So the ball is spotted at the 44-yard line of the Rams. First down and 10. Hackett under center. Hands off to Payson, who just had the interception. He tries to go up the middle, but not much going there. Colin Clifford in on the tackle, along with number 55. See if he's on my roster. 55.
Brian Preglovic.
Thank you,
Captain, for Meslonsky.
Brian Preglovic. Second down and 8. Two men split left. The handoff goes to Ricky Dexter, the fullback. And he stopped after a gain of 1, maybe 2. And it's going to be third down and 6.
Ricky Dexter there with the carry, as you said, going to the left-hand side on that one, trying to go over the side of Eric Anderson and Ben Bambrick, who was filling in for Jeremy Tyler. Gets a couple yards on the play.
Third down and 6. Hackett pitches to Payson. He runs to the right. Gets swarmed close to the first down stake. This is going to be a close one. Colin Clifford again in on that stop, along with Wayne Evans, number 81. They spot the ball. I believe it's going to be shy of a first down.
Could be very close, that's for sure.
Payson with a nice run right there. Brought it right outside. Cut up a little bit to give Bangor, hopefully, a first down.
It won't be. It's fourth down. Fourth down and a yard.
Let's see if Bangor's going to go for it.
And now they'll call for a measurement. It's going to be short.
A game of this importance for each team going for home field advantage, they want to get it right.
Yeah, I'll tell you what the problem is now, though. They've spotted the ball. They said it was short, and then they brought it into the hash marks. If they were going to measure, they should have spotted the ball, left it there, and brought the chains out to where they spotted the ball.
I agree.
So it is short.
Big decision here in the early third quarter.
They're changing personnel, so it looks like they're going to go for a kick. You're with the wind. The wind has picked up here in the second half.
Ricky Danny Dexter looking like, is it Dexter back there who's going to kick the ball?
The
or is
punter
that
is T.J. Vananastein.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Vananastein takes the punt. Gets it up into the wind. This is a nice punt. It'll be fielded. Caught by Duffy, lets it bounce into the end zone. A little too much on it for Vananastein, so Meslonsky will take over from their own 21st down and 10 when we return. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week.
When you have an important point to make, don't clutter up the ad with all sorts of extra information. if Page Employment doesn't charge workers a fee, then we should just say that. Page Employment doesn't charge workers a fee. No fee. There, we said it.
Northeastern Log Home's four-star promise, to design the dream home that's perfect for you and your family, to ensure your home will be built with materials of the highest quality and durability and offered at a fair price, to deliver a complete easy build package with more of what you need, like Anderson Windows, Owens Corning Shingles, and Morgan Doors, to provide factory direct expert assistance every step of the way for as long as you own your home.
Come visit us in Kandeskeg and we'll help build your dreams with our experience.
Welcome back to Cameron Stadium. Homecoming for Bangor. Two 6-1 teams meeting up here in week 8 of the regular season, the final week of the Class A regular season. Messalonsky ball, first down and 10. They have a 14-7 lead. The handoff goes to Chris Duffy, and he is swarmed and won't get anything.
Duffy going to the right.
Trundy was right there, and Andrew Trundy's big to run over, 6'7", 270.
Duffy trying to go over on the side of Colin Clifford and Luke Fakita again, one more time. But as you said, he was stopped in the hole. Excellent job by Bangor.
We want to thank Northeastern Log Homes for making this broadcast possible. They offer quality log homes, so thank you to them. Second down and 10. Man in motion is Matos. The pitch goes to Duffy. He gets around the outside and is knocked out of bounds at the 33-yard line by Van Anistein, but he has another first down. He turns that corner so quickly, and once he goes upfield, he's gaining big chunks of yardage.
Van Anistein, a nice little stop there, keeping him to the outside so he didn't cut it back up to get him out of bounds.
Unofficially, Duffy is 1 yard away from breaking 100 yards. 14 carries, 99 yards.
Nick Payson was pushing Duffy to the outside on that one. He just couldn't trip him down.
First down and 10. This time it's Cody in motion. He goes to the right side. Duffy takes the pitch and tries to follow the block of Cody. Brought down by Ricky Dexter.
And Mike Pike right there on the tackle. Mike Pike came up nice and fast, stayed on his block, but made Duffy bring the ball upfield rather than taking it to the outside.
Injured Messalonsky Eagle down on the field. McPike's a junior who was in on that hit. So an official's timeout will take it as well. 7:57 to play here in the third quarter. Messalonsky leads it 14-7 over Bangor. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week. Welcome back to Cameron Stadium. The injured Messalonsky Eagle was Colin Clifford, one of their captains, their right guard. He's now off the field. He jogged off on his own power, so we hope he's all right. 7:44 and running to play. 14 in the third quarter, I should say. 14-7, Messalonsky leads Bangor. We want to thank Quality Jewelers, who offer fine jewelry, for making this broadcast possible. Flag down on the play, and it's delay of game.
Delay of game against Messalonsky.
5-yard penalty. That was a quick play clock.
Colin Clifford, number 62, just went out on the injury for Messalonsky as one of their guards. And they've been running right over to the right side of him all night long. So let's see if Bangor can take advantage of them bringing in a second string person to come in.
I'm not sure if Clifford's going to stay out too long the way he ran off the field. We'll see if he gets right back in there. So another flag down on the play. See what this call is. Lining up in the neutral zone. Offsides. Lining up offsides. Messalonsky. Second time we've seen that call. So we had back-to-back penalties against Messalonsky. They lost 10 yards without running a play.
Or taking a snap of the ball.
Or snapping the ball, correct. They had a delay game penalty after the injury. and then they lined up offside.
Let's see what Maslansky's going to do against Bangor's defense.
Second down and 18. Fabian has completed 5 passes on 10 attempts. He has 1 interception. That was the last attempt he had. This time he gives the ball to Duffy. Tries to get around the corner. He just gets large chunks of yards. And it doesn't seem like, it seems like he's being strung out, but once he decides to turn it upfield, he picks up 7-8 yards at a time.
Exactly. And again, number 34, Nick Payson, a junior from Bangor, makes Duffy go to the outside. He holds off the inside line for him, so he's got to cut to the outside.
10-yard pick up there. Third down and 8. So I hear the schools interested in Duffy include Colby, MMA, Wesleyan, UNH, Plymouth State, Ithaca. Well, he has the speed this year. He just doesn't have that much size. This time, he's wrapped up.
Duffy, low down by the other.
After a short game, Aaron Gallant. No gain on the play. No, he was able to get a yard. Fourth down and 7.
That little list you named off for Duffy is quite the little list that school is looking for you. That is very nice for a junior from Maine.
Yeah, very impressive.
Very.
Anytime a young man like that can further his education, go to a
by several different schools. Yeah,
absolutely. Especially like a Colby. That's very impressive.
As I mentioned earlier, 3 Bangor players are interested in going to Ivy League schools. And I understand they have the grades to go. And fumble on the snap, and they won't get it off. Fabian under pressure, tries to get away, and he can't.
That's what happens. That's that. Didn't get a chance to get it off. Bangor gets excellent field position right here.
Was it Aaron Smith, number 77? I believe Aaron Smith made the tackle finally in the backfield after a loss of a bunch on that play.
Nice to see Aaron Smith, senior from Bangor High School, come up with a big play in his last home game.
So a big loss on fourth down, and Bangor has the best field position. They started the drive yet tonight. Down by 7 with 6:24 to play in the third quarter. The handoff goes to Payson. Payson. He is close to a first down.
Bangor with Payson going right up the middle over Andy Gould and Kyle Oliver.
He picks up 11 yards and a first down.
Payson all night is 13 for unofficial 89 yards so far. Starting to gain yards.
This could be a turnaround for the Bangor Rams right here.
Anthony DeRosa comes out wide right. He's still coming out wide right. He's split in because there are 3 guys behind Hackett. They give to Payson, right up the middle. Payson, along with Craig Lucas.
The wind is starting to pick up a little bit in this game. Temperature's dropping.
Wind is blowing left to right. That's the way Bangor is going right now. 8-yard gain, second down and 2. The handoff to Payson right up the middle, trying to follow those big offensive linemen. Stop just shy of the end zone. It'll be first down and goal from as close as you can get without getting in.
Payson following number 70, Andrew Trundy, a senior of Bangor. Stand right behind him and just follow that big boy. 270 pounds of pure boy right there. Big line right there.
First down and goal. It's Payson. Dives over the top and he is in. Nick Payson scores the touchdown for Bangor with 5:19 to play. A 1-yard touchdown run, and 1 yard is generous here.
Payson going right up the middle over the top of Andy Gould, their center. The guard of number 76, Kyle Oliver. For Bangor's second score of the evening, first score of the half, second half that is.
That was quite the leap Mr. Payson had. Looks like LaDainian Tomlinson there for a second.
He certainly did. And he held on to the ball.
And now look at what's going on here. Bangor doesn't have the kicking tee out, so they're going to have to burn a timeout because they don't have the tee, unless they're going to move it back 5 yards and kick a 25-yard extra point. And they get called for delay of game.
Because
they couldn't find the tee.
Don't they usually have one person on the sideline who hangs on to that? Apparently not.
Well, if he was, he was at the very far end of the lineup, which is unfortunate.
You can see, it's Bangor's homecoming. They got all their freshmen out here also suited up tonight.
So this is a big point with the score 14-13. Messalonsky leads by one. Tyson Barron's kick is up, and he has plenty of leg on it. The penalty doesn't affect him at all. They could have taken four more of those penalties. Barron would have been able to kick it through. The point is good. We are all tied up with 5:19 to play in the third quarter. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week.
No matter how you stack it, Page Employment has jobs.
Northeastern Log Home's four-star promise, to design the dream home that's perfect for you and your family. To ensure your home will be built with materials of the highest quality and durability and offered at a fair price. To deliver a complete easy build package with more of what you need, like Anderson Windows, Owens Corning Shingles, and Morgan Doors. To provide factory direct expert assistance every step of the way for as long as you own your home.
Come visit us in Kandeskeg and we'll help build your dreams with our experience.
Welcome back, everyone, to Cameron Stadium. A tie game here, week 8, is exactly what you would have hoped for, because both these teams come in at 6-1. Both these teams hoping to host a first-round playoff game next week. But for them to do so, both these teams need to get a win here tonight. And we're tied up in the third quarter with 5:19 left to play. Bangor will be kicking off to Messalonsky. Tyson Barron, the kicker, back to receive. Chris Duffy and Danny May, they kick it to Duffy again. Duffy picks it up at the 15-yard line. Duffy goes up the middle and is brought down by Nick Payson.
Nick Payson in on that tackle right there. Stopped him in his tracks.
Absolutely.
On that one.
All I saw were feet coming up in the air on that hit.
Payson's quite the busy little athlete out here tonight. He's not cold.
He is. And it's nice to see his grandmother and grandfather from Dedham here. We love to see the Payson clan here for the big homecoming night.
Duffy's been busy as well. Payson and Duffy, both busy, both the leading carriers on their respective teams. Duffy, 17 carries, 113 yards, and he's back there again right now. He gets the call. He runs to the right side. Still on his feet. And finally stopped. Always seems like the whistles come late when Duffy's carrying the ball. That's because he's still moving, even though we don't actually see him.
He keeps his feet moving on every play until they knock him off his feet. You keep your feet moving and head down and run forward.
Gain of 4 yards on the play, second down and 6. We want to thank Carpet One, specializing in carpet and tile, for making this broadcast possible.
Duffy going over number 63, Clifford Collin, who went out on that interception play of the last possession from Messalonsky.
Second down and 6. Ball handed off to Duffy. Tries to get around the outside. Gets away from one tackler. Tries for the corner. Doesn't have it. He's going to reverse field. He's way back there now, and Nick Payson brings him down. The line of scrimmage was the 31-yard line, and he lost 20 yards on the play because the line of scrimmage will be the 11.
Aaron Smith on that tackle right there did not let him get away. He's a senior for Bangor.
Wow.
Third and a while.
Bangor looking to capitalize on this right here with a third down and 26.
That was a huge play.
Excellent play. I think, Duffy should have went down.
He should have
tried to make something out of nothing, because he was, half of Bangor Rams defense was all around him. Duffy did make a couple people miss, though. He made TJ Bananastein miss, Nick Payson miss.
It would have been a good play for him just to get back to the line of scrimmage, which it looked like he had done, but when he decided to try and make more out of it, he ended up losing a lot. Here he gets another chance, but he's not able to go anywhere. Picks up maybe two, but it'll bring up fourth down and forever, and Messalonsky will send their punt team out.
And there's Duffy going over the right side of their line, trying to go over Colin Clifford.
So fourth down in a while. Not only does Messalonsky have to punt here, but they have to punt into the wind with 3:07 to play in the third quarter. Fabian's the punter, back in punt formation. Tom Cruise and Anthony DeRosa back to receive it. It's going to be DeRosa, and he calls for a fair catch at the 39-yard line. That's where Bangor will start in Messalonsky territory, first down and 10 when we return on the Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week.
Selection without service would be like sunshine without the warmth. Our jewelers have the experience and the tools to renew, repair, or even create jewelry with the warmth of real quality. We're Quality Jewelers. Browse in our new, larger location across from the Fleet Bank building on Exchange Street in downtown Bangor.
When you have an important point to make, don't clutter up the ad with all sorts of extra information. If Page Employment doesn't charge workers a fee, then we should just say that. Page Employment doesn't charge workers a fee. No fee. There, we said it.
Some of the fans at this game here tonight, some of the future football players. First down and 10 for the Rams. Brian Hackett gives the pitch to Payson. He turns the corner, splits two tacklers, and is brought down after a pickup of 7 yards.
Payson going to the right side on that one, trying to take it all the way outside and go up the sideline. Gets a few yards out of that. Gives Bangor again excellent field position to try to take the lead back in this game.
On second down, they give to Payson. He tries to break it out left, cuts back inside, and will pick up a first down. Brought down by Ted Fabian, but not before he picks up a first. He moves the ball shy of the 25-yard line, and it's first down. First down and 10.
Payson going to the left on that one, trying to go over Eric Anderson and Ben Bambrick. Following the big boys over on that right, left-hand side, 6'3", 280 for Bambrick and 6'3", 250 for Eric Anderson. Anderson a senior this year, his last home game.
Messalonsky takes a timeout. That gives us a chance to thank another one of our sponsors, Carefree Windows and Siding. They offer 1,300 different colors of siding. Carefree Windows and Siding, another sponsor to thank for making this broadcast possible. Nate Long, along with John Clifford and Howard Kroll, Pam and Eric Baxter on the cameras tonight. This is the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week, and it's been a good one so far. The wind picking up, though, and blowing some papers around. It's getting chilly.
It's getting chilly, and looks like Nick Payson's just starting to heat up. He's got 18 carries for an unofficial 115 yards, so he's starting to add up yardage on every carry.
Back-to-back carries of 7 yards. Set up the current situation. First down and 10 for Bangor at the 25 and a half yard line.
Bangor's offensive line is giving Payson some good holes, some good running room to move around out there. You've got Eric Anderson, a senior, up on the front line. 250, 6'3". That's a big body to follow.
Absolutely.
Home field advantage in the first round of the playoffs. Up for grabs here. One of these teams will be 6-2. One of them, 7-1. The difference between those two records is the difference between going on the road or staying home in week one of the playoffs. Payson got the handoff, but he tripped immediately and may have picked up a yard on the play.
Payson going over Andy Gould, their junior, their center, and Kyle Oliver, a senior for Bangor. Get tripped up there.
Second down and 9. You like that, Howard?
I like that.
Payson.
Good run, Nick.
Wrapped up after a gain of a little more than a little this time.
I would say probably about five.
Ryan Cormier, the nose guard, the junior, 5'9", 240, coming out to make that tackle. Ball spotted at the right hash mark. It's third down and four on the 20-yard line.
Let's go, Payson!
Third down and four. Hackett keeps it himself, and he will be close. Ran around the left end.
That right there was a design play for keeper for Hackett. He was keeping that thing all the way on that one. That was a completely design play.
And we will have a timeout for measurement. There's less than a minute to play here in the third quarter. Bangor's going with the wind right now. Wind's blowing left to right. The score is tied 14-14. We're either going to have first down and 10 for the Rams or fourth down and less than a yard.
He's got the first down.
Looks like a first down. And it is.
It's got to be the nose of the football on that one because they took a little bit of time to decide if it was a first down or fourth down.
I think they wanted to bring Messalonsky's captain over. I think Ralph Dameron called Messalonsky over and pointed out how little they made it by, but that they did in fact make it. So it's first down and 10 at the 16-yard line for the Rams. Clock running, 44 seconds left in the third quarter. Payson gets the call right up the middle.
Payson taking it right over again, the guard, right guard for Bangor, Kyle Oliver, taking it right over him, getting another 5-6 yards out of that carry.
Curtis Baker, number 66 on the stop. Second down and five, 19 seconds to play in the third quarter, three backs behind Hackett. We've seen this formation much of the second half from Bangor. This time they go to Dexter, the fullback. And Dexter stopped after a gain of a couple by Jamie Bonnell. And that will be the final play of the third quarter. Our score, we're all tied up heading to the final period. 14-14. These teams equal in record and equal in score thus far. We have one more quarter to decide who goes to 7-1 and who gets to host a first round playoff game. We'll have the final quarter for you right after this break. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week.
During our lifetime, priorities change, and we begin to seek out products that enhance our lives. We move and we grow and come to realize what's truly important. We begin to understand the value of our time and see the results of investing wisely. Priorities change, standards don't. Paradigm Windows of Portland, Maine. Window solutions for life.
Available from Carefree Window and Siding Company. Call 989-4260.
Security. You know what it means, and now you know where to find it. Seaboard. If you're responsible for a school, business, healthcare facility, or any other organization, the only word you need to know when it comes to keeping your facility secure is Seaboard. Because your students, customers, patients, employees, all the people who depend on you can depend on us. You just have to remember one word. Seaboard.
Welcome back, everyone. Bangor Messalonsky tied at 14 here in Bangor's homecoming. Both these teams have won three straight games. Both these teams are 7-1. Both of them lost the same week 4 weeks ago. Messalonsky lost to Mount Blue. Bangor lost to Skowhegan. Neither team has lost since. Third down and three. The handoff goes to Payson. Rams have the ball. Payson picks up a first down. And he is down inside the five. Looks like he's even inside the 3 yard line.
Looks like he's inside the three right there. Looks
and
like they're going to spot it.
First down and goal for the Rams to start the fourth quarter.
Again, the Rams going with their running game right up the middle, going right over Andy Gould, a junior for Bangor.
Well, it's worked. If you look at Payson's carries this game, Payson into the end zone, touchdown Bangor. 2 yard touchdown run, Nick Payson.
Nice run there by Payson. Took it right up the middle again, going over the right side of Kyle Oliver and Andy Gould, going right to that side. They both pushed their defensive guys back for another Bangor score. The second score of this half.
Bangor's Nick Payson's second touchdown of the game. Both of them coming in the second half. Tyson Barron on to attempt the point after. The kick is up. And it is good. Bangor has a 7-point lead, 21-14.
Crowd starting to get back into it now. Bangor's up, crowd getting motivated.
Looking at Payson's carries there during that drive, he had the touchdown carry the previous drive, and then this drive that we just saw, 7 yards, 7 yards, 1 yard, 5, 5, 6, 3 for the touchdown.
That's a workhorse if I've ever seen one. And he plays defense, 23 carries for 136 yards. I mean, that is impressive.
On the other side of the ball, Chris Duffy having a game as well against the Bangor D. Well, the only drawback for Duffy was that time he lost 20 yards trying to make something out of nothing. He now has unofficially 99 yards, but that's deducting 20 yards, so he was well over 100 for a while.
Nick Payson also plays hockey.
Payson does play hockey,
yes,
as well as
does.
Many Messalonsky players. Craig Levisk is one of them, the captain. Their center, Jamie Bonnell, he plays hockey. Ted Fabian, their quarterback, plays hockey. And we should note that the Messalonsky hockey team met Bangor in the playoffs last year, the first round of the playoffs. Bangor ended up winning that one. Here's the kickoff. And it is returned out to the 35-yard line. Nice return on the play.
Excellent return on the play.
Luke Collier, number 11.
Chris Duffy in on that play right there.
Messalonsky ball, first down and 10 at the 34-yard line. They trail by 7. Plenty of time left. 11:31 to play in the fourth quarter. They are going with the wind, as evidenced by the balloons blowing past us. The wind blowing from our left to right. Fabian will pass. He rolls out to his right to buy time. Gets a pass away, has a man open. It's Dan Merrill, complete. Big pass play there from the 35 of Messalonsky all the way down to the 24 of Bangor. 31-yard pass completion.
Matos taking off again from the far right-hand side, comes across the field.
I believe
Fabian,
it was
Merrill rolling to the right. Was it
Merrill?
Was it
89?
I'm just so used to saying Matos.
Yeah, Matos
got,
has
got
a lot of
there.
Them. He does have a lot of them, but Merrill stepped up and made a couple, and that was one big one there.
Andrew Glant with a nice save on that tackle.
First down and 10, three backs behind Fabian. Collier was the one who was in motion. Fabian under pressure, gets the pass away, and it's incomplete.
Alex Glenn almost picked that thing off.
He was right there to defend it. He almost had it, and actually the intended receiver turned into a defender there.
And knocked that ball down just to make sure that Mr. Glenn didn't run that thing back down and open this game up again to a 14-point lead.
Saved an interception.
Alex Glenn, only a sophomore for Bangor.
Second down and 10. So right there on that play, Luke Collier was the tailback, and I'm trying to find Chris Duffy on the far sideline.
Keep playing, Alex. Come on, big man.
Duffy back in the game? No, it's still Collier. Four. No word on what happened to Duffy. Duffy wasn't back on the kickoff return either, which he usually is. So Collier's back there now. He takes the handoff and is swarmed at the line of scrimmage.
Duffy trying to take it to the right on that one. Bangor's defense picking it up just a little bit to make sure they don't give any easy yards to Duffy. He's had a lot of, I'm not going to say easy yards, it's not easy, but again, he's had a lot of yards this game. They're pounding him and pounding him.
It's not Duffy, it's Collier still in there. Luke Collier with the carry. A senior, number 11. He's still in at tailback.
My apologies on that.
He has been the last couple of plays, and
yep.
We're trying to see if Duffy's, they're treating someone on the Messalonsky sideline right now. We can't see what number that is because we're being blocked. In the meantime, Collier gets the carry, tries to get around the outside corner, and he comes close to a first down. He's spotted down at the 15-yard line.
Collier bringing it to the left-hand side, quick pitch to the outside, taking it, gets a good block out front of him, brings it up to almost a first down for them. Looks like they got about a yard to go.
Fourth down and a long one. 9:47 to play and running. Bangor crowd starting to pick things up and trying to get a fourth down stand here. Three backs behind Fabian. He hands it off to the middle man,
Cody.
And it was a first down. I believe it was Matos as well.
Thought he gave it to Cody. It's a long way from here. Don't have binoculars.
Mesolonsky does pick up a first down. Matos has been the second back in that formation all night, so I believe it was the second back through who got the carry. It was enough for a first down, and that's what's most important to Mesolonsky right now. First down and 10, the ball inside the 15, down at the 14-yard line. The tailback is still Luke Collier. But they're going to pass. Fabian, under pressure, tries to get away. He does. Now he's going back to the left. Flag down on the play, an illegal block, and this one will come back. Fabian was able to manage to get back to the line of scrimmage. He somehow scrambled back to the line, but the penalty will move them back 10 yards.
Aaron Smith, number 77 for Bangor, again, playing his position quite nicely to hold Fabian in position. Almost had him for a sack. He's been there a couple times. He's been very close for a sack when Fabian drops back for a pass. So
10 yards from the spot of the foul, so this is going to move them way back to the 31-yard line, and they have to get to the 4-yard line for a first down. So first down and 27 when they, at one point, had the ball inside the 15.
Collier still in the backfield.
It's an option. Fabian keeps it, and he gets tackled from behind by Kyle Oliver. He gets the ball back inside the 20-yard line.
Nice little fake there by Fabian, as if he was going to pitch the ball to Collier, but he keeps it and gains another 10 yards.
A manageable second and 17. Let's go. 8:03 to play here. Bangor leads it 21-14. Home field in the first round of the playoffs can be decided tonight. Fabian, same play, other direction. This time he pitches to Collier. Collier tries to cut back in the middle, finds a hole. Nice running there by Collier. We hadn't seen him at all in the first half. He's come in to replace Chris Duffy, the all-world quarterback Mesolonsky's been using, halfback, I should say, tailback that Mesolonsky's been using. Leading the PTC in yards, Collier's come in, and he's looked good as well. It's third down and 4.
Fabian with a nice keep on that one. Excellent pitch to the outside. He was wide open. I mean, he had some running room.
He's made the right decision both times they ran that option play. The time before he kept it, picked up big yardage. This time he pitches it and they pick up big yardage. Third down and 4. They try the option again. Fabian, this time, can't get rid of the ball. Number 70, Andrew Trundy with the hit.
Nice saving tackle right there. Fabian, I think, would have got the first down.
Fourth down, call it 3. Decision time, and Mesolonsky wants to think things over. 6:39 to play. Big play coming up. Fourth down and 3. Mesolonsky trails by 7, but they have the ball inside the 10-yard line. We'll have that play for you when we return. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week.
So, you want a fish?
This one.
That one?
That one.
This one?
That one. These ones are cute.
That one.
There.
This?
That one. Blue one.
Face it, people like having choices. That's why we've got thousands of floors to choose from. Carpet One.
Hey!
matter how you stack it, Page Employment has jobs.
Free samples, right?
That's one of our most popular flavors.
No.
No.
Berry marshmallow.
Purple swirl.
This one.
There you go.
Maybe.
Can I get you a cone?
I'm still deciding.
Face it, people like having choices. That's why we've got thousands of floors to choose from. Carpet One.
Welcome back to Cameron Stadium. Fantastic game here tonight for the Page Employment Seaboard Security's Game of the Week. Two teams that are 6-1 battling it out here on week 8, the last week of the regular season, and it's a close one. 21-14, Bangor has the lead in the fourth quarter. We want to thank Bangor Tire, caring for all your automobile needs, as one of our sponsors making this broadcast possible. Big play right here. Fourth down and 3. Meselonski down 7. They have the ball at the 5-yard line of Bangor, or 6-yard line, we'll call it.
Big play here, big play.
Fabian under center. Hands off to Luke Collier, and he is tackled for a loss. Nick Payson.
Payson in on the tackle.
Getting the job done for the Bangor D. We'll see where the ball is spotted. That's where Bangor will take over, wherever they put it down. Big loss on the play.
Nick Payson gave him a big, giant bear hug and was not letting go.
The ball moved out to the 14-yard line, so Bangor with 6:33 to play.
Penalties have been so big for Meselonski.
That's really true. They've had a lot of penalties. Just about every drive, it seems like they've either had to overcome penalties or they haven't been able to and have had to give the ball up. That drive right there was stalled because of a huge penalty, a block in the back that moved them and made it second down and almost 30 yards. First down and almost 30 yards. Bangor's first play, short gain, brings up second down and 9. Another sponsor we want to thank while we have the chance is Bangor Optical One, vision care for the whole family.
Josh Cody in on that tackle right there, number 36.
Second down and 9. The handoff to Payson. He gains 3. It'll bring up third down and 6.
Payson's going to be the workhorse now. With less than 6 minutes to go in the game, looks like Bangor's going to try to keep it on the ground and hold their lead.
I don't know.
But they need a couple first downs.
Right. They're not
going to have the first down.
Still too early to just run
Wait
the ball
it out.
Sit on the ball because Meselonski's been able to pass the ball rather efficiently this game. They've lost their big tailback, Chris Duffy. We're not sure what happened to him. We didn't see him get hurt, but he hasn't been in the game here lately. Handoff goes to Payson. He's met by number 72, Luke Fekete. And he was able to push Fekete far enough to pick up a Bangor first down. Fekete, 6 foot, 200 pounds. Met Payson behind the yard to gain. But Payson used his momentum, still going forward. Picks up a first down.
Very important first down from Bangor right there. Keeps the clock going.
First down and 10. Hand off to Payson. Short gain on the play.
Again, Fekete in on that tackle. Forgive me if I'm pronouncing
Fekete.
That. Thank you. Fekete in on the tackle. Off Ben Bedicta and Eric Anderson side of the field trying to give them another first down. They're short by about 5. Bangor needs another critical first down here.
Clock running, 4:24. Now it's going to become a factor. Second down. Full house backfield. Hand off to Payson. Works his way inside and then back out. Still on his feet. And he picks up another Bangor first down.
Payson going right up the middle, going off to the left side of Andy Gould, and Eric Anderson cut it to the left side and took it again to the sideline. Big first down for Bangor right there.
Cut it outside. He ran up the middle and then cut it outside, picked up the first down. and it's first and 10, clock running. We want to thank Angelo's Pizzeria for their support. Bangor Canvas as well, covering all your canvas needs. Corner store, Gabby would like to say great job to all the football players and Timothy Woodcock, attorney at law specializing in litigation, for making this broadcast possible. First down and 10 from the 42. Bangor with a 7-point lead, 3:47 to play in the fourth quarter. Payson just fell over the line of scrimmage there.
Payson going over the right side that time, trying to go over Kyle Oliver, and literally went over.
Tried to. Number 55, Preklavisk, able to make the stop.
That was Payson's 29th carry for 161 yards, so he has been the workhorse.
Definitely the
ball
the workhorse for Bangor.
161 to show and two touchdowns.
He's got to hang on to the ball for the next 3 minutes and 10 seconds.
He gets the call again, and he breaks it outside, leaves one defender in his tracks and crosses midfield. He's close to a first down. We'll see where they spot the ball. It looks like he has it from here.
I have to say that on that play right there, Mr. Payson took Danny May and stopped him and just didn't. It made Danny May sit there and kind of wonder which direction he was going to go.
Yeah, he kind of got lost in his tracks.
He most definitely did. Excellent run by Mr. Payson.
Absolutely.
They're working him a lot, keeping him in the game. He's run the ball out of the last, I'd say, four or five plays.
He's run the ball every play this drive.
Absolutely.
The officials are looking whether or not this is a first down. And we will have a measurement. I know one of the captains, Brian Preklavisk, was called over to look at this. And it is homecoming here at Bangor. 3:03 to play in the fourth quarter. And Bangor looking to hold on to a 7-point lead. So far this drive, they're doing a good job of it. I'd be shocked to see Bangor go to the air again. Hackett, this game, 3 completions and 9 attempts, 2 interceptions. It is a first down for Bangor.
Big first down right there for the Bangor Rams.
3:03 to play. Clock will wind, I believe. Do they call them inbounds or out of bounds? I guess we'll find out. They call them out of bounds, so the clock does not wind. They're at the 48-yard line of Meselonski.
Meselonski looking to create a fumble, a miscue, anything right here with 3 minutes left.
And Payson looking to hang on to the ball. Well, not Payson, Dexter this time. Dexter tries to go up the middle.
Dexter going over Eric Anderson and Ben Bambrick.
Might have gained a yard on the play.
Giving Mr. Payson a little break there.
Chris Webb in on the stop for Meselonski. After a gain of a yard, 2.5 minutes we're approaching. Left to play in the fourth quarter. Hackett hands off to Payson. Flag down on the play. I believe this is going to be a legal motion. This looks like it'll be a legal motion on Bangor.
I think so right there. Payson again going over the names I've said several times, going over to the right, the left-hand side of Eric Anderson and Ben Bambrick.
The penalty is a legal motion against Bangor. And the reason is Mike McPike, when he came in motion, started running towards the line of scrimmage slightly, not running forward, but running. His momentum was going towards the line of scrimmage, so that's an illegal shift. You can't do that, and it's a 5-yard penalty.
It's a break for Meselonski right there. That is a good break for Meselonski. 2nd and 9 for Bangor. If Meselonski can hold, they may get the ball back, only if Bangor doesn't score first down.
Well, it was a replay of the down, so it'll bring up 2nd down and 14. With 2:16 to play in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely gorgeous night for football, though.
Little chilly to stand
it's
in the stands.
It's okay. It's not that bad. It's not that bad.
Nice night if you're playing on the field, that's
exactly.
For sure.
Well, you know one young man that's had a lot of opportunities to touch the ball, Nick Payson. 30 carries, 171 official yards.
Unofficial.
Unofficial yards. Thank you.
Yes.
Official to us, though.
I would never say that.
Second down, 14. Payson breaks two tackles, beats another guy, still going, and is knocked out of bounds. Flag down on the play.
Late hit on that play right there. I think that's what they're going to call. He was definitely out of bounds on that.
Yeah, Payson had given up on the play, and he still got bumped. Not bumped hard,
but enough to get a flag. Payson going over again, the left side of Ben Bambrick, a 280-pound, 6'3 junior for Bangor.
So Payson had picked up close to a first down. It looks like he had the first down without the penalty. This will just tack on 15 more yards.
Bangor just looking to hang on to the ball right now, secure themselves a victory, and give themselves a home field advantage in the first playoff game.
The ball moved to the 22-yard line of Messalonskee, 1:51 to play. Bangor leads by 7. This has been an impressive time-consuming drive when the Rams needed one the most. Hand off to Payson.
Payson again going over the side of Eric Anderson and Ben Bambrick. I think I've said that a lot just on this drive right here. He has definitely been using that left side of Bangor's offensive line with the workhorse of Eric Anderson and Ben Bambrick filling in for Jeremy Tyler.
Gain of 4 yards, second down and 6. Clock continuing to run. 1:15 to play, fourth quarter. Hand off to Payson, right up the middle. Delivering a blow and then being tackled at the 15-yard line.
Keeps his feet moving, forward progress.
It'll bring up third down and 3, 1 minute to play here in the fourth.
I would like to correct myself. Number 63, Jeremy Tyler, is in the game. He has been on the left side alongside Eric Anderson.
Timeout, Messalonskee. They call a timeout with 55 seconds to play in the fourth. Bangor leads at 21-14. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week.
1928 Bangor Tire was founded on simple concepts, offer quality products, price them right with service second to none. Vehicles have changed a lot over the years, and Bangor Tire leads the way with today's best products and service, like Cooper Tires, Monroe Shocks and Struts, and Walker Exhaust Parts. And the Shine Shop will make your pride and joy shine like new. So whether your car or truck needs brakes, a front end alignment, exhaust, some TLC, or the best in tire service, count on the folks you've trusted for 70 years, Bangor Tire Company.
When you have an important point to make, don't clutter up the ad with all sorts of extra information. If Page Employment doesn't charge workers a fee, then we should just say that. Page Employment doesn't charge workers a fee. No fee. There, we said it.
Fifty-five seconds to play here at Cameron Stadium. Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week. It's been a battle. Two teams that have postseason hopes. Both will be going to the postseason. Both hope to make a statement in the postseason. Bangor leads this one 21-14. They've put together an impressive drive here to try and seal the victory. They face a third down and 3. They give the ball to Payson. He cuts it back inside, and he has a first down. That will probably seal it. He picks up a first down right at the 10-yard line, 48 seconds left to play. And depending on Messalonskee's timeout situation, Bangor might be all set to take a knee and call it a game.
Let's hope they do that, because there's one thing you don't want to see, and is that is a miscue and a fumble right here.
Well, unless you're a Messalonskee fan, then you're really hoping for that.
Yeah, exactly.
Impressive drive here by Bangor to maintain the clock and to move the chains and keep Messalonskee's defense on the field.
Really has been.
Coach Littlefield has to be proud of his players tonight. I mean, they came out here, gutsy effort.
Bangor takes a timeout with 19 seconds on the clock. I don't understand
that one right there. maybe to clarify something to make sure they don't do anything crazy.
Well, they're probably close to getting a delay of game penalty and didn't want to do that.
Yeah.
19.7. I don't like when football clocks have the point, the tenth of a second. You don't need that in football.
No, not in football you don't.
You don't need it in football or hockey, in my opinion. It's fine in basketball.
True.
It's just, I mean, a game doesn't ever come down to the tenth of a second.
At least not this game.
Like you mentioned, John, Messalonsky's really got nothing to be ashamed of. If anything, they could take something from this game and hopefully learn from some of their miscues, especially on the penalties.
Well, if these two teams meet up in the postseason, Messalonsky, if they do end up dropping this one, will still feel like they had a chance to win it and won't come into Cameron Stadium if Bangor is hosting, won't come into Cameron Stadium feeling overmatched, that's for sure.
Absolutely.
Brian Hackett takes a knee. And that will likely be the final play of the game. The Bangor players running onto the field. A homecoming victory for the Rams. 21-14 in a hard-fought battle. Bangor just slightly better in this one, but they get the job done. That is the final tick of the clock. Bangor gets the win. 21-14 over Messalonsky. They go to 7-1 on the year. Messalonsky drops to 6-2. That means Bangor will, in all likelihood, host a playoff game here next week at Cameron Stadium. Messalonsky will likely have to go on the road. We'll come back to wrap things up here at Cameron Stadium. After this, you're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week.
During our lifetime, priorities change, and we begin to seek out products that enhance our lives. We move and we grow and come to realize what's truly important. We begin to understand the value of our time and see the results of investing wisely. Priorities change, standards don't. Paradigm Windows of Portland, Maine. Windows solutions for life.
Available from Carefree Window and Siding Company. Call 989-4260.
A victorious Bangor squad celebrating a homecoming victory tonight, 21-14 over Messalonsky. Before we get to the stats, we had a little confusion over who was wearing number 11. We were calling it Luke Collier because he's number 11 on the roster, and we're looking for Chris Duffy, whereas number 2. Apparently, Duffy had to change jerseys, so most of the fourth quarter when we were calling Collier, it was actually Duffy. So, in fact, Bangor did a pretty good job to stop Chris Duffy, who was the leading ball carrier in the PTC. That confusion out of the way. Howard, do you have some stats for us?
I do. Chris Duffy, a.k.a. Luke Collier, had a total of 24 yards for 113 yards. Josh Cody had 4 carries for 13 yards. Justin Maddox, 5 carries for 19 yards. Ted Fabian, 4 carries for 14 yards. And Danny May, 1 carry for 5 yards for a total of 164 yards on the ground. Ted Fabian, the quarterback, went 6 for 11, 153 yards with one interception. 2 catches by Wayne Evans for 69 yards and 4 catches by Justin Maddox for 84 yards.
So Collier was actually Duffy.
Actually Duffy.
Well, we didn't know it. There's no way to find that out.
Absolutely.
Okay. So for the Bangor side.
For the Bangor side, the workhorse, and I'm putting that in a very generous term, Nick Payson had 34 carries for 195 yards. Ricky Dexter, 4 carries for 6 yards. Brian Hackett, 2 carries for 6 yards. Brian Hackett, also the quarterback, was 3 for 9. 2 interceptions for 56 yards and 1 touchdown, and that touchdown was the Anthony DeRosa's first play of the game for 56 yards. Interesting note, Nate, Messalonsky outgained Bangor. Messalonsky had 317 yards, Bangor had 263 yards. So it was costly in the turnovers as well as the penalties, and that was probably the difference in this game.
And Messalonsky scored a touchdown, too, on a defensive play. So
Messalonsky. Right.
Messalonsky played well. They definitely played well. Here's a scoring recap. Bangor got off first. 11:44. That's just 16 seconds into the game. Brian Hackett, 56 yards to Anthony DeRosa. 56-yard touchdown pass, 7-0 Bangor. Ted Fabian came back with a 2-yard touchdown rush for Messalonsky. At 1:19 in the first quarter, the point after was no good. They tried 2. didn't get it, 7-6 Bangor led. At the 4:20 mark of the second quarter, Ted Fabian, the 28-yard interception return for a touchdown, put Messalonsky on top of this one, 14-7. Then Nick Payson came back in the second half. Payson in the third quarter at the 5:19 mark, 1-yard touchdown run, tying the game up at 14. Then Payson again in the fourth quarter, the game winner, 2-yard touchdown run at 11:37 to make it 21-14. That was our final. Bangor gets the win. They go to 7-1. We're going to talk to some players and coaches on the field when we return. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week.
Free samples, right?
That's one of our most popular flavors.
No.
No.
Berry marshmallow.
Purple swirl.
This one.
There you go.
Maybe.
Can I get you a cone?
I'm still deciding.
Face it, people like having choices. That's why we've got thousands of floors to choose from. Carpet One.
So, you want a fish?
This one.
That one?
That one.
This one?
That one.
These ones are cute.
That one.
There.
This?
That one. Blue with...
Face it, people like having choices. That's why we've got thousands of floors to choose from. Carpet One.
Welcome back. We're here with Coach Littlefield after this game. Coach, first of all, can you explain to us what happened with Duffy? We got confused about the numbers because all of a sudden we had a number 11 out there and we didn't know where number two went.
His jersey got ripped off him, so we had to put number 11 on him in our spare jersey bag. So that's what happened with that.
So it wasn't intentional?
No. I think they were just trying to, reach for the jersey to slow him down a little bit, but that's what happened with that.
I just meant no deception on your part.
Not at all. No deception on our part. He got it completely ripped off his back, so we had to put a jersey on him and get him back out there.
Now, as far as the game itself, you guys came out here, you had some big plays, and then they had some big plays, and pretty much they had one more big play than you guys.
That's basically how it went. I felt we dominated the first half down here, and they left a lot of lanes open for our passing game off our play action with Chris. So we wanted to attack that tonight, and we did a good job with that. Take away the big play, the first play of offense. It's a different game here, too. So we were pretty happy with our performance tonight.
A passing game that unofficially had only 220 yards coming in, had 110 at halftime.
Right, yeah. I mean, that was our plan, too, to kind of get that out and get it working because we've had it all year. We just haven't had to use it.
And now it's something that you might be able to use from this point on. You know you're in the playoffs. You knew that ahead of time. So it probably gives you guys confidence going into next week that, hey, if we have to pass the ball, we can.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. We want another shot. Bengals are a good football team, but I felt like there were some calls out here that were definitely questionable tonight. So we'd like another shot. I wouldn't mind coming right back up here next week.
And you might get that shot.
Yeah, we might get that shot. I'd love it.
Okay, Coach, good luck. Thanks for joining us. Thanks very much. Right. Now we're going to go to John, who has Coach Hackett.
Hi, I'm here with Coach Hackett. Coach, great game tonight, great effort by the kids. How's it feel to know that you have home field advantage for the playoffs?
You know what, it's real nice to be home. We keep saying it doesn't make that big a difference as long as you're playing, but it makes a difference. It's great to be home, it's great for the fans, and it's great for the players.
Excellent. Knowing that this game was that important, coming out of the halftime, what did you tell your boys that they had the key on?
We knew they were going to make some plays, and we let up a touchdown on offense. So we were all a little bit miserable at half, but we felt we were a stronger football team, and we just had to keep our composure, make a few slight adjustments, and just keep playing and try to keep the big plays down. And they made some big plays, but we kept them out of the end zone.
Speaking of big plays, you have a big player in your backfield, Mr. Payson, absolute workhorse. Any words for him?
Yeah, we get the game ball in that. We never give it to a junior, and we just felt the junior had to get it. Gave it to a senior still, Eric, but Nick deserved the game ball also. He was a stud tonight.
Coach, thank you very much. Excellent job tonight. Now I'm going to turn it back over to Nate, who has some players from the Bangor High football team.
All right, thanks, John. Back down here on the field with a couple of guys who had pretty good offensive performances tonight. We'll start over here with the quarterback, Brian Hackett. First, Brian, you guys came out and threw the ball on the first play from scrimmage. You got a 56-yard touchdown.
Yeah, it was a good play. We worked on it in practice. Everything went how it's supposed to, and Duriska made a nice catch, good time in the pocket, and scored a touchdown.
Now, this guy over here, he had a pretty big game when you needed him, too. Nick Pacey, you got the game ball. You had a huge game. Your team needed you to come through in that last drive. They needed to keep the ball on the ground, and you were able to move the ball.
The line was getting fired up, and we were getting some first downs. So, I mean, we had a lot of life in the huddle, and we were just kept on driving it down the field.
Not only that, but you made some big plays defensively as well.
We had a good hard practice on defense this week. We're mainly concerned about the run with Duffy in the backfield, but I mean, they came out with some passes, and I mean, that caught us off guard, but we managed to hold them.
You guys came into this game knowing it was a big game, knowing that if you won, you got to play here again next week. How's it feel now that you got the win?
It feels good. It was a good, hard-fought victory. Linemen played well. Everyone played well. We came together as a team. We get one more game here.
Brian Hackett, the quarterback, Nick Payson, he got the game ball as a junior, the tailback. Both these guys will be playing at home this coming weekend because they got the win here tonight. We'll wrap things up after this break. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week. Back here at Cameron Stadium, a 21-14 win for Bangor when they needed it the most, John.
Excellent, excellent game between two 6-6-1 teams fighting for their home field advantage. You couldn't ask for a better game. It didn't come down to the wire, but still it did come down to a few good plays.
Two teams that want to meet up again next week, at least Coach Littlefield and Meselonski. You heard him say he does. I'm sure Bangor wouldn't mind playing these guys again, too, because it was that good of a game. Both these teams competitive, they both are going to be in the playoffs, and they both have a good chance to go far in the playoffs. We'll see what happens. That does it for homecoming at Bangor. We're here at Cameron Stadium, and you've been watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week. For Howard Kroll, who had to leave, John Clifford, I'm Nate Long. Thanks for joining us, and we hope to see you again at the next Page Employment Seaboard Securities Game of the Week. Good night, everyone.